Hello and welcome to the ORM Mastery course. This tutorial is part of a bigger course which you can access via the YouTube edition playlist link, which you'll find in the video description. If you really like this tutorial and want to learn more, then please check out our Django ORM Mastery course on Udemy. The link to the course, which will always provide the best price, can be found in the video description. In the previous tutorial, we learned how to create a receiver function and listen for a specific signal. In this tutorial, we take that forward and look at how to receive a signal from a specific sender, as well as look at how to connect the receiver function utilizing a receiver declarator. So we start off where we left the previous tutorial. Inside of the apps module here, we created our receiver function. We're utilizing the post save signal, and we created the connection inside of the ready function here. Of course, you might build multiple signals, and it's not necessarily the best place to add all these signals inside of the apps file here. So let's build a signals file, and we're going to place all the signals within this module here. In the previous example, we utilized the .connect function to actually connect our receiver to our post save signal. This is one of two ways we can connect receiver functions. The second way, like I said in the preview, is that we can utilize the receiver declarator. Now, you may not be familiar with a declarator, which is a design pattern in Python that allows us to add new functionality to an existing object without modifying its structure, for example. So let's just explore that slightly. So let's go into signals here. Let's bring in, import our receiver, and then we're going to create our receiver declarator. To understand this, let's just follow the lead here. So django.dispatch. So let's explore Django. If I type in Django GitHub into my browser here, into Google, let's go over to GitHub where we'll find the Django code source, or the source code even. Then let's go into Django and let's go to dispatch. Now inside of here, you'll notice that there's no reference here to what we referenced in our receiver, and that was import receiver. If you explore a little bit, we have this initialization function or module, sorry, here. So let's go inside of here and have a look, and you see what's happening is that when we call Django dispatch, we're actually running this import. So signal and receiver from the dispatcher here, Django dispatch dispatcher. So if we go back one and have a look in the dispatcher, this is where we're going to find at the bottom the receiver function here. So essentially what's happening here with our declarator is we're adding functions, appending this receiver function and adding functions to this existing function. If you can read the code at the bottom here, so if I can zoom in a little bit, you can see what's happening here. So for every receiver function that we've created, you can see that it's using the connect function to try and then connect that receiver to the specific function that's been designated to the receiver function that we've created. So you can see the code in place as well and see what it's doing there. So where we saw in the previous tutorial, we utilized connect. Now we're using the receiver declarator to essentially append our function here. And then it utilizes this function down here to then actually run the connect statements for each of our functions, our new receiver functions, so that it connects to our signal. So we're going to specify two attributes here in the receiver function. We're going to pass in two attributes. That's the signal that we're going to use. So I've brought in from DjangoDBModels.signal, import post save. So we bring in post save and then any keyword arguments that we want to pass in. So that's going to be the quarks. So now underneath this, we can place our function. So let's go back into apps. Now I've already removed the import. So I'm now going to remove this function here inside of apps. Just bring this in. So there we go. So it's going to perform the same function as before whenever we save. But this time we're going to specify a model, of course. Anytime we save to a specific model, we're just going to print out instance is saved. Now to specify a specific model that we want to use, we're going to remove the keyword arguments and actually add a new keyword argument, which is going to be sender equals and then the name of our model, which is going to be product or category, whatever model you want to actually send the signal from. So here we've got product. So in our models, we have the product table. So we're going to need to just import that in. So from .models, let's go ahead and import product. Although this is a very simple example, the likelihood is that we are going to need information related to the data that's saved in the product model when we then go ahead and run our post-save signal over to this new function. So we can pass in additional information. So for example, we wanted to pass in the instance that was saved in the product model over to our new function here. And potentially we can also then check to see if the data was actually saved correctly. So created would return, for example, a Boolean back, and we can determine whether the data was actually saved or not in the product model. The final step here is for us to actually register this new module. So it is initiate or run when the application starts. So for that, let's go back into the apps.py module here, and we can go ahead and just add this into the ready function at the bottom here. Whereas before we called our function, which was directly in the apps file, now we just need to import the signals and then place that within our ready function. So let's go ahead and do that. We can do a direct import here. So for example, import e-commerce, isn't it? e-commerce.apps signals. Okay, right. So import e-commerce.signals. That should do it. So let's now test this out. So let's go into our shell, and we need to from e-commerce.models. Let's go ahead and import the product table this time. Now the product table only has one field. That's the name at this point to make it nice and simple for us to work with it. So product name equals test. And then let's go ahead and save. So you can see as soon as we save, the signal is sent out. We have connected within the apps file here our signals. So those were initiated when the app was initiated within our project. And you can see here that the signal was sent, it was captured, and our instance is saved. So that's the print return from our receiver function. We could go ahead, of course, and just print out some of the other details that we passed in. So let's go for the instance, and then let's print out the created just to show that was working. So let's do that, created. Okay, so let's go back, I'll press up and I'll bring back the previous command, press save, and you can see that the instance is saved. So it's not actually printing the instance and created. So what we're gonna need to do is just exit this again, let's just, for the sake of completion, let's just exit and then let's do this again. So go back into our shell. Let's bring in our product again. I'm just pressing up to bring back the previous commands, and let's go ahead now and save. Oh, that was category. So there we go. From that. Okay, so product name equals test and save. So we're just going to run that save again. And this time you can see that we have returned the other information, so instance and created. So the data was added to the database. So we returned true from created. And you can see here that we return the instance as well as just printing out instance is saved. So unlike the previous example, this is only going to be captured on the sender, which is the product model. So you can go ahead and just test that out if you want to. So from e-commerce, let's import category. So from e-commerce models, let's import category. And then let's just save to the category table. And you can see this time that signal obviously isn't being captured and we aren't outputting because we've specified the sender, in this case, the product model.